This is brought to you by the strange, the bizarre, the unusual. I like it on both Facebook and YouTube.
Third, none from there on. Four times a day, he gets gold chloride injections. Every 2 hours, he takes a tonic. At its height, the clinic in Dwight treated 700 patients per day. Keeley claimed that when his medicine was administered according to his direction, it had no injurious effect. About 95% of the patients were permanently cured. If they did return to drinking, he insisted that they were cured, but that they drank because they chose to do so, not because they were still addicted. Keeley published numerous articles in the popular press, in addition to pamphlets promoting his therapy, and wrote The Morphine Eater, or From Bondage to Freedom, in 1881. Heredity of Inebriety in 1896. The Keeley Institute in Dwight was the last to close, doing so in 1966. A proprietary method of treatment by means of gold chloride. American Institute Medical Pictures, 1938 picture. That's for the Keeley cure. You guys want to find out more information about him? From what I found out with Keeley, the majority of his recovery rates was actually not the gold cure, but he was one of the first people to come up with the idea of one alcoholic helping him. He also set up a network where people who were addicts and alcoholics would not only stay there and take these gold cure treatments and recover, but they would also go out and recruit other people to come back to the centers, and they would do the process, and then they would go out and do the same thing. So not only were they going through one alcoholic and addict helping another, but they were all actively going out and finding new people. In the end, that's what they figured out, or that's what they said was actual help these alcoholics. A lot of people did recover, but after Keeley passed away, his cure was lost. Those recovery rates just vanished. Gimmicks don't work. You know, Alex Jones talked about these kind of things in his videos and on his shows, you know, about taking colloidal silver. A colloid is a substance microscopically dispersed through another substance. The dispersed phase particles have a diameter of between approximately 2 and 500 nanometers. Such particles are normally invisible in an optical microscope, though their presence can be confirmed with the use of an ultramicroscope or an electrical homogeneous mixtures with a dispersed phase in this size range may be called colloidal aerosols, colloidal emulsions, colloidal foams, colloidal dispersions, or hydrosols. The dispersed phase particle or droplet are affected largely by the surface chemistry present in the colloid. Some colloids are translucent because of the Tyndall effect, which is the scattering of light by particles of colloid. Other colloids may be opaque or have a slight color. Colloidal solutions, also called colloidal suspension, are the subject of interface and colloidal science. This field of study was introduced in 1861 by Scottish scientist Thomas Brann. Because of the size of the dispersed phase, may be difficult to measure. Colloidals can be classified as follows based on the nature of interaction between the dispersed phase and the dispersion medium. Colloidals can be classified as hydrophilic colloids. These are water-loving colloids. The colloid particles are attracted towards water. They are also called reversible salts. Hydrophobic colloids. These are opposite of nature to hydrophilic colloids. Colloid particles are repelled by water. so-called irreversible SOLs. In some cases, a colloid can be considered a homogeneous mixture. This is because the distinction between dissolved and particulate matter can be sometimes a matter of approach, affects whether or not it is homogeneous or heterogeneous. A hydrocolloid is defined as a colloid system bearing a colloid particle or hydrophilic polymers dispersed in water. A hydrocolloid has colloid particles spread throughout the water depending on the quantity that are available to take place in different stages, e.g. gel or SOL. Hydrocolloids can be either irreversible, single state, or reversible. For example, a reversible hydrocolloid of seaweed extract can exist in a gel state and alternate between states with the addition or elimination of heat. Gelatin desserts like jelly or jello made from gelatin powder, another effective hydrocolloid. Hydrocolloids are incorporating food mainly to influence texture or acid of a sauce. Hydrocolloid-based medical dressings are used for skin and wound treatment. Other main hydrocolloids are xanthan gum, gum arabic, tar gum, locust and starch. Following forces play an important role in the interaction of colloid particles. Excluded volume repulsion. This refers to the possibility of any overlap between hard particles. Electrostatic interaction. Colloidal particles often carry an electrical charge and therefore attract or repel each. The charge of both the continuous and the dispersed phase, as well as the mobility of phases, are factors affected in the interaction. Van der Waals forces. This is due to interaction between two dipoles that are either permanent or induced. Even if particles do not have a permanent dipole, fluctuations of the electrons' density gives rise to a temperature dipole in a particle. This temporary dipole induces a dipole in particles nearby. The temperature of the temporary dipole and the induced dipoles are then attracted to each other. This is known as Van der Waals force. Hydroponic force. According to the second law of thermodynamics, a system progresses to a state in which entropy is maximized. This can result in effective forces between other spheres. Then you have steric. When polymer-covered surfaces are a solution containing non-absorbing polymer and modulate interparticle forces, producing an additional steric repulsive force, which is predominantly entropic in origin, or in fraction depletion. Such an effect is specifically searched, tailor-made super plasticizers both to increase the ability to concrete and to reduce the content, getting it to jello, gel, and concrete. That's what you're getting. Little gold is a suspension alloy of sub-micrometer size particles of gold made fluid, usually water. The liquid is usually either an intense red color, the particles less than 10 nm, or blue-purple, the larger particles. Due to the unique optical electronic and molecular recognition property of gold nanoparticles, they are a substance of substantial research. Applications in a wide variety of areas, including electron microscopy, electronics, nanotechnology, and material science. Known since ancient times, this thesis would have gold method of staining glass. Oil gold has been used since ancient Roman times. Color glass and shades, depending on the concentration of gold. In Hindu, various potions. A so-called elixir of life, a potion made from gold, as if not actually manufactured times. Now, you're also being introduced to the same problem. Stained glass. Medical uses of silver includes its incorporation into wound dress creams and as an antibiotic coating of medical devices. While wounds dressing contains silver sulfadiazine and silver nanomaterial may be used on infection, there is little evidence to support such use. If you guys get into all these supplements, just remember this is what you're putting in your body. Hope you enjoyed what you heard. Please like, subscribe, and share.
This is brought to you by the strange, the bizarre, the unusual. I like it. Thanks for watching. If you like the video, please like, subscribe, share, and make comments. We love feedback.